Now, I take from the earlier slide, I take x is equal to a sin omega t. Okay, this is the equation finally I wrote in the previous video, and this is video 3, right? And what is a? A is equal to amplitude, right? A is equal to amplitude, right? What is amplitude? The maximum distance through which the body has traveled from neutral position, right? That is A, right? What is omega? Omega is angular velocity, right? Angular velocity. Angular velocity, suppose if the particular body moves through a distance x, x means the vertical ordinate, right? And A is, if a circle is drawn with A as radius and x as vertical ordinate, right? Then when a mass at radius of A is revolving, then the angular velocity will be omega, right? And what is time? T equal to time, right? And if you take this, x is equal to A sin omega t. So as I explained in the previous video, right? So corresponding to that, it will travel through for any particular theta, that is omega is to t, right? So theta equal to omega t, right? For any particular theta, right? This will be the displacement. Or for any at any particular time, when the body, this is the neutral position, and it goes up and down like this. At any particular time from the beginning, right? At any particular time t, right? The displacement x will be, x is equal to a sin omega t, right? A sin omega t, right? Where a is the maximum displacement through which it has gone from the neutral position, and time is at any particular time t, and a is the maximum displacement or amplitude, and x is the displacement at c. If it moves like this, and this is the neutral position, I just keep my right hand as a neutral position, and this body goes like up and down like this. At any particular t, it starts from 0 here, and at a time t, what is this vertical distance? That is x, and that is given by this, right? And a sin omega t, right? So this formula gives at any particular time the vertical distance through which the body has moved is given by this formula, right? So what is this? Omega? Omega is nothing but it's the angular speed, right? Angular speed is angular speed into distance is nothing but theta, right? So angular speed, with this we'll stop, right? Because video 3 it is stopped, right? We'll go for a small derivation, right? So displacement at any particular time x is equal to a sin omega t, right? So at any particular time, at time t, dx by dt, right? Or velocity of that particular mass. See, if your neutral is here and the mass moves like this, at any particular time, what is the velocity with which it is moving? That is given by v is equal to, we have to differentiate this, dx by dt, right? When you differentiate it, the answer will be a into omega into cos omega t. If you differentiate it, you will get this, right? And now what I do, I want to find out the acceleration, that is, a is equal to dx square by dt, that is equal to, if you differentiate this once again with respect to t, then what you will get? Omega square, right? Omega, once again omega will come. So omega square to a into
sin omega t,
right? So this will be minus, right? So if you differentiate cos, it will get minus sin omega t, right? So what is a omega t? A sin omega t is nothing but x, right? So what will be the result? Minus omega square x into what is this? A sin omega t is x, right? Omega square x. right? So the what is this? The finally what you get? A is equal to minus omega square x. Right? Do you understand? So A is equal to minus omega square x. So if A is minus omega square x, then see here, acceleration is proportional to x. What is the x? X is the displacement through which the body has moved from neutral position, or vertical distance through which the body has moved, right? So x is proportional to, A is proportional to x. So from the, since the beginning itself I told you, if a body follows acceleration or force being proportional to the vertical displacement, then it follows into harmonic motion, right? So if I write this equation, for example, see, A is equal to minus omega square, that is what is that? D square x is equal to this, right? So this means what is that? So that means d square x divided by dt square, dt square is equal to, what is the, what is get? Minus omega square x. This is nothing but A, right? So understand? Yes. So if you understand this, okay, what I do? So this minus I am bringing this side, right? This term, I am bringing this side of the equal sign, right? So if I get it, if I do that, so d square x plus omega square x is equal to 0, right? So this is the equation of simple harmonic equation, right? This is the equation of simple harmonic equation. And the same thing we are getting in the case of acceleration of force developed by the body at any particular time, right? So as the simple, excitation or the natural frequency of vibration follows this equation, and as this equation is the same as simple harmonic motion, which I derived based on the circle and wave theory, right? Both are same, and so this natural frequency of vibration or oscillation always follow simple harmonic motion, right? So simple harmonic motion means it follow definitely this equation, right? So if any motion that follows this equation is called a simple harmonic motion. Also here, if you find that A is proportional, this is A, nothing but A, and A is equal to minus omega square x, and A is proportional to x, right? Where x is the vertical displacement at any particular time t, right? So whenever your acceleration or force or anything attributed vector is proportional to the vertical displacement x, it is always said to follow simple harmonic motion, right? So and from with this equal, with this setup, with this basic concept only, we are going to derive the whole equation for finding the simple frequency of simple harmonic motion later on, and all the derivations are going to be based on this particular concept and fundamentals for the video course.